Did you know, around the middle of the Earth, that there is an imaginary line that we call the equator? Everything north of this line is known as the Northern Hemisphere, and everything south of this line is called the Southern Hemisphere. Do you know which hemisphere you live in? There is another imaginary line going through the middle of the Earth, called the Earth's axis. The Earth spins on this axis once every 24 hours, and this is what gives us night and day. Daytime is when our side of the Earth is facing the sun, and nighttime is when we are facing away from the sun. The Earth also moves around or orbits around the sun. One single orbit we call a year. So what is a solstice? The Earth does not sit upright when orbiting the sun. It actually sits on a tilt of approximately 23.5 degrees. This means that as the Earth orbits the sun, the amount of daytime and nighttime across different parts of the Earth changes every single day by a few minutes. This is also the reason why we have different seasons. At two points in the year, we get a solstice, a summer solstice and a winter solstice. The summer solstice is the day where we get the most daylight hours in a day, also known as the longest day. In the Northern Hemisphere, this date is between the 20th and 23rd of June. In 2023, the summer solstice is on the 21st of June. In the Southern Hemisphere, the summer solstice is exactly 6 months after ours, so this year it will be on the 21st of December. Every day after the solstice, the amount of daytime will start to reduce by approximately 2 to 3 minutes a day until the winter solstice occurs, which is the shortest day, and this cycle repeats annually. The summer solstice is a big event for many people around the world and has been for thousands of years. Stonehenge is a famous site, consisting of a circle of stones, and was built around 5,000 years ago. Every year on the summer solstice, the sun perfectly aligns itself with the stones that make up Stonehenge, and is a site which many travel for from all across the globe. In Austria, people light bonfires at the top of mountains to worship the earth. In Stockholm, Sweden, people celebrate by dancing and singing. This is called the Midsummer Dance. Since they are quite far north on their hemisphere during the summer solstice, it doesn't actually go dark, and places further north than that can get months of continuous daylight, with the sun never quite setting. What did you learn about the summer solstice today? Why not check out the Twinkl website to see what resources are available to celebrate the summer solstice?